The AFC West has a lot of questions going into this offseason. And I mean a lot. What's going on, guys? Dix Report here, back to you with another video. And this time I'm going over the AFC West offseason preview. I'm jumping right in with the Denver Broncos. Alright, and the Broncos season was very, I don't even have words to say. They got hurt by injuries early on, and then they had problems at their quarterback position, especially during the week where they had no quarterbacks and they used a practice squad receiver as their quarterback. Big question for them heading into this offseason. Do they think Drew Lock is their quarterback of the future? If they do, then that makes this offseason all about building the team around him. If they don't, that means they need to find a new one. This is a very big offseason for the Broncos, whether they think Lock is the future or he's not. The good news for the Broncos is they can build this team because they have $42 million in cap space. That's a really good number to have. They can make some moves during this offseason. First things first, they got to figure out what they're going to do with Justin Simmons. Justin Simmons got the franchise tag last year. He could get it again this year, but he is due for a big-time deal because he's been a very good safety. He's been one of the top safeties in the league for the past few seasons. He is definitely due for a pay raise. I don't know if he's going to get it this offseason because, like I said, the Broncos could just flat the franchise tag on him again. But he's been a very good safety. He definitely deserves an extension. A few positions that they could improve during the offseason, one of which is the cornerback position. They've got to find some quality corners for this team on the defensive line. Jarrell Casey's getting up there in age. They lost Derek Wolfe in free agency last year. They got to start rebuilding this defensive line. And at the running back position, Philip Lindsay has been a very solid running back, but he's also been a little injury prone, and the other running backs have not been able to handle the load. Might be smart to get another running back on this team. And they're drafted 9th overall. They can get a really good player at 9th. Could just take the best player available. Or if a quarterback falls to them, they don't think Lock's the future, they could just take that quarterback. It's up in the air with what the Broncos do during the offseason. Kansas City got back to the Super Bowl last year. However, they could not beat the Bucs, and it was partly because they could not protect Patrick Mahomes. Offensive line is a big need this offseason. They got to improve that offensive line so that that does not happen in 2021. They also need help at the cornerback position. Breshad Breeland is a free agent, and I don't know if the Broncos are going to be able to re-sign him because they are $25 million over the cap. They've got to move some money around, got to be able to make some tough decisions, and they might not be able to re-sign Breeland. And also, they need help on the edge. Frank Clark is basically the only guy for Kansas City that's been able to get to the quarterback on the edge. Got to be able to find some others. Chris Jones has been a really good defensive tackle to get to the quarterback, but they've got to find some guys on the edge. And with them picking 31st overall, it's all going to depend on how that board falls. If a really good player falls, then they'll take him. If they don't think there's somebody worth taking, they'll try to trade out of it. With those last few picks in the first round, it's all depending on how the board falls. The problem with the Raiders the last few seasons is the fact that they have not been able to finish. With the Raiders, they got themselves in position to get a playoff spot, but then they just fall off a cliff during the last few weeks of the season. John Gruden's coming back for another season. Can he get this team back to the playoffs? That's a big, big question for this season. They're another team that's over the cap, but they're only over by $7 million, so it's not too hard to move some money around. And with their top free agent, it's Nelson Agholor. They signed Nelson Agholor to a one-year deal, and he was able to make some plays for them during critical moments of the season, but I don't know if they're going to want to re-sign him. And they're picking 17th overall, so they should be able to get a really good player, an impact player there. And in terms of what they need, it starts with the defensive line. Now, Max Crosby has been a pretty good defensive end, but Khalil Farrell, who they drafted 4th overall, has not made the impact that they thought he would. Might want to get him some competition there. They also need help on the interior of that defensive line. Keep improving your defensive line. They also need help with the safety position. Jonathan Abram was drafted in the first round, but he's a liability in coverage. He's a box safety. They need to get some help over there. They need to get a center fielder. And they also could benefit from getting some more depth on the offensive line. Keep protecting your quarterback and opening up running lanes. Improve the offensive line. For the Chargers, they took Justin Herbert with a 6th overall pick last year, and they took some criticism for that. But Herbert proved to be the best rookie quarterback out of that class. Now they got to build the team around him, and that starts with the offensive line. They've got to be able to get better on the offensive line to protect Herbert so he's not running for his life. They also need help at that cornerback position. Casey Hayward and Chris Harris are in their 30s. They've got to get younger at the position. And they also need help on the edge. Joey Bosa is a bona fide star in this league, but Melvin Ingram's getting up there in age. They've got to get younger and help out Bosa on the edge. and they have $23 million in cap space, so they should be able to make a couple of moves, and they got to make a decision on Hunter Henry. Hunter Henry, when he's been on the field, has been a very good tight end. They could re-sign him, give a safety blanket to Herbert, or they could just let him walk in free agency if they think they can get somebody better. We're not sure what they're going to do. They're picking 13th overall, so they're in really good shape this offseason to help build around Herbert and build a playoff contender. All right, guys, that was the AFC West. Next up is the NFC West, and I'll see you next time.